Well, good morning. It's raining. It's blowing quite a lot, to be honest. And this is the start of MB06, 14th of March 2019, 04:52 hours. Recorded in the car due to inclement weather. I'm going to take it nice and easy. I think that's my best plan. This will direct me. I was thinking it might look a bit lighter earlier, but with this cloud cover, not particularly so. Speak to you from Hereford, because that's where I'm going. Well, I'm sure it's light, it's windy, there's not quite as much rain. However, there is rain. I'll travel lodge. Side pocket for a toad. I think it's just called side pocket trim, and I might have had it before. 3.6%. Nice bit of carpet. Had a word with the duty manager. Curry's from 8 o'clock. It's now 9:10. The bar is now open. Wall to wall Brexit on the TV. And we have power. So, off we jolly well go. A bit cool. Cold, actually. Nice citrus lemon aroma. Tingly on the tongue. Citrus lemon, nice and refreshing. If only there wasn't a 70-mile-an-hour gale warning. Citrus bitter long finish. It is B-plus in a bit. That's not a bad point. And very sessionable. Probably what I'm going to need today. I've had this one before. This is Winter Glow by Strathaven. 5% alcohol by volume. The King's Fee seems to be meet-up location because it's quite close to the station. But people going to the Cheltenham Festival. Lots of horse riding. Racing aficionados. Yeah. Anyway, carpet, Mr. Manning. Did I say 5%? 5%. Rich. Burgundy whiskey, barrel aged. A bit spicy. Yeah, B+ on the board. It's well made. I'm no expert, but I think the small bowl of chips is a large bowl of chips. Jalfrezi, bargees, punk IPA, condiments. Oh my. I'm not surprised they don't have the sign outside. It would blow away. It is mighty, mighty windy today. Sheltering from the wind. This is brewed, not brewed on site, but brewed by the people who own this place. I've got the name of After the Harvest, and it's a mild, house mild, 3.6%, which is just as well, because sneaky, real floral, Mr. Manning. Slight malty aroma. I would say fruity mild. That's very nice. B+ in a bit. Struggling with the language time. This is, I'm taking a stab. Hedra gantiorenisia. Gaelic. Cloudwater and the White Hag Brewing Company from Era. We're doing a tap takeover here on Saturday. Anyway, Nitro Black IPA, 6.2%. Beer House glass. Nice head. Ooh. Fruit
fruity aroma. Huge coffee hit. Bitter finish. That's good. That's wrong. B++. The thing about beer is you learn something new every day. I remember my Michael Jackson's World Pocket Beer Guide taking me around Europe. Beer's about people. Anyway, this is from Lowlanders, which I think in Dutch is Nederlander. I could be wrong. Anyway, this has, and this is what I didn't know, yuzu, which is lemony from Japan. It's only 2.5% alcohol by volume, which is just as well, because I could still do the siesta. Oh, grapefruit as well. Intense citrus aroma. Oh, sharp and really rather refreshing. I like that. And although the sun's out, it is nippy out. So I'm going to say this is the sort of beer I need on a day like this, B++. Same brewer, same brewed with botanicals. This is the IPA, however, 6%. Brewed with coriander seeds and white tea. Citrusy, hoppy, and bitter with a refreshing note of spice. Brewed on glass. Warming, lightly spiced, tastes strong. I don't know, that's a really good beer. I think I can get the tea. I'm going to say B++. It's working. Always had a soft spot for Newcastle. They have weather. This is Wylam, and it doesn't say prepared by, but there you go. Chasing mirrors through a haze. Yep, it's hazy. So 7.1% alcohol by volume. That's my lot for today. It looks like very good. It smells like very good. It's a fruit bomb. It's juicy, it's fruity. I really like that. I'm gonna say A-, 3.75 untapped, which is unusual for me, but hey, it's great.